Good day, YouTube. Today I'll be pulling out my BMS 25 Woodmizer sharpener and showing you how I just throw it together and then sharpen a couple of blades. I've had a couple of run-ins with some metal and have quite a few blades that are a little bit dull. So let's get this going. And voila, it is done. as you can see, I'm just barely nicking the fronts and the backs of the teeth. I've got a little bit of profiling issue with my grinding wheel here. I went too far back over here with it, so I need to take the tool and dress it up, make it a little bit flatter on this back end, because it should come straight down flat with a little bit of an up curve to it. So with this, you notice I'm getting very little spark at the beginning, get a little bit more towards the end. I'm trying to get the kerf there. I believe it's called the kerf. The dip in the blade ground out a little bit more too, making sure that I have the teeth sharpened and to a bit of a point there without changing the degree of the blade itself. So this is a lot faster than doing it by hand, but I still have to go and adjust it a little bit lower each time. Take a little bit of cuts every time, or a little bit of grinding every time. Because if you do too much at once, I've been told you can get what's called blackening on the teeth, and I think that's just overheating of the tooth and completely ruins it. So if I'm wrong, correct me on that. Let me know. Just showing you what blades got. Two here to go, two there to go, then one hanging up over there. If you look here closely, this was one that I ground before and I kind of screwed up. See how the teeth are pretty black? I think that's what they were talking about, that blackening. It's no good. It still cuts, but I think it just kills the life of your blade and your teeth. So, and all this rust I'll take off by hand with a little wire brush afterwards, so it cuts smoothly through the wood.